Hello, everyone, and welcome back to our, relatively brand new Road to the Show character, Tommie Johns. Tommie Johns, our new starting pitcher, and he is working through the Topps showcase. We're getting right back into it here. Game number two in that showcase, where he will pitch a few innings again, I would hope, and impress some scouts, I hope, even more. So where will Tommie Johns end up in the draft? Well, that is something that needs to be decided here after he showcases his skills, but right now we're getting ready for this second Topps showcase game. You got scouts in attendance, you got friends and family in attendance, you've got everybody here checking out the best prospects that both the U.S. and international venues have to offer. So Rex Mora will be pitching for the East today. Good luck to him in getting drafted. But we are focusing on our guy, obviously, Tommie Johns, the sidearmer. And he'll be pitching to Fritz Cox. He'll be the first batter up here. So here we go, Tommie Johns wearing that 23. And if you haven't seen his motion before, it's a little jarring there, seeing a starting pitcher coming at you sidearm. And just wait till he throws that knuckleball. Hopefully going to be very deceptive with that motion and with that pitch especially. So he's got one out. He's got a 3-1 count to his second batter. That's got to be particularly hard being a lefty hitting against him, yet he comes up with a hit. So maybe that theory doesn't hold as much water as I thought it might. I don't know. We'll see. These prospects are all good out here, too. They're all trying to show off and get drafted. So this is going to be a ball put in play. And the third baseman is going to come up throwing, and he gets the out. So there's two down now. Runner moving up to second base. Let's see if Tommie Johns can work through this 1-2 count with two outs. That one kind of floated to the plate, and it is skied in the air. Second baseman gets back there finally and makes the catch. So Tommie Johns strands the runner and just the one hit against him in the first inning. Let's go to the second now. And the first batter works a 2-2 count. That pitch is popped up in foul territory. Tommie going to go get it himself? Nah, his first baseman should get it. And he does, over by the on-deck circle, making the catch. We got one down. See if he can make this a 1-2-3 inning. That would be pretty sweet if he could. Pitch coming to the left-hander, and there you go. That's where I'm talking about it being a little tricky. Left-hander seeing that sidearm motion coming like right at you, basically. And then whatever action that pitch has, either into you or away on the outside of the plate, he's got definitely, I would think, an advantage with that look against left-handers. Usually lefties versus lefties is a good match for the pitcher anyway, but I would think doubly so the way he throws the ball. This is going to be hit at third, and we should have our 1-2-3 inning. Very nice, Mr. Tommie Johns. Pitching well through two innings in the showcase. My guess is he would probably get three innings total, so this might be the last 3-2 count. Strike three, swinging. Looking good, looking good. He's got one out in the third if this is his last inning. He wants to make a count. So getting the strikeout under his belt. And we've got a replay on this as well. Where does this end up in the zone? Kind of outside half of the plate. Puts it in a place that's enticing to swing, but also a place where he's not going to touch the slider. And he swings for strike three. 0-2 count quickly to the next batter with one out. And is it put in play? Yes, it is, but right back at Tommie. Gonna flip this on over to first base, and he's got out number two. So showing that he can field this position as well. Good to know if you're the scouts that he can do a bit of that. So through 2 2/3 now, just the one hit, and he's got two strikeouts. Will this be the last batter he faces? Let's find out. A 1-1 count. With those two outs, it's a right-handed batter. He puts it in play. It's going to be hit it short. The throw to first. Got him. 1-2-3 inning again. Want to see if he comes back out here or if that is going to be it. If it is, that's a nice outing for him through three innings. Yep, that will indeed be the end of his pitching performance here in the showcase. Got to give other guys like Marco Marquez their spotlight as well. So Tommie Johns out of the game. Just kind of wait around and see what happens here, what the result will be. They didn't have a run on the board, so I don't think he's going to pick up a win in this game. But the Central does win. It's really secondary to how these guys show off for the scouts individually. Then, you know, I don't think anyone's going to remember the Central won this game here in the showcase, but it's still a nice feeling. I always want to win, preferably over losing, so we'll take it. Now, with that in the books, I think we have an MLB draft to look forward to. And we'll just have to see where everything falls now after we've performed on the field. And their last look at us was a pretty good one. So I would hope that would carry some weight into the draft and that we might end up in a good spot to start our pro baseball career. Tommie Johns just giving up that one hit, looking solid, the two strikeouts in his three innings of work. Pretty efficient day for him. Really didn't have to work too hard there as far as base runners and all of that stuff. So what do we got? I think it's time to talk to our agent here and prepare for the draft.
With nothing left to do but await his fate, this young hopeful receives a check-in from his former high school coach, who's been acting as his advisor through the process.
All right, have a little chat with our former coach here ahead of the draft. Just kind of sorting some things out. We don't have an agent yet, so he serves as our advisor to this point until we actually go and sign an agent. That'll probably happen after we get drafted somewhere and need representation. But for now, just kind of the back and forth conversation going on, filling some time and killing those nerves here for Tommie Johns before he's got to sit through this draft and wait for his name to be called. All right, it's time for the MLB draft, and we're in round 23.
Welcome back to the Major League Baseball First Year Player Draft. The first pick is officially on the clock. With the first pick, the Detroit Tigers select Barney Pack, a relief pitcher from the International Region. With the ninth pick, the Baltimore Orioles select Tommie Johns, a starting pitcher from the Central Region.
Okay, that's interesting. We've been drafted by the Baltimore Orioles. That's also where Billy Bravo started his career. I don't know. Do we want to settle for that? Or do we want to go back into the showcase, go back to school, do whatever? I don't know. We're going to have to think about this a little bit.
After a long and lonely first 2 days of the MLB draft, this player's wait is finally over.
So it's his advisor and former coach checking in again here, basically talking about what his options are, either accept this draft by Baltimore and head to the minors, or, you know, maybe consider going to college and re-entering the draft at a later date. So what is he going to pick to do? What is Tommie Johns going to decide to do? Kind of a big choice here, you know, it's only your future in professional baseball, or maybe not in professional baseball. Maybe college baseball. Depends on which way he wants to go. Does he want to get more seasoning? Does he want to get drafted higher than the 23rd round? I mean, you know, he's not exactly a blue chip prospect. It would appear by this conversation with the advisor that Tommie Johns has decided to re-enter next year's draft. He's going to play some college ball. So we're right back at Bowman Scout Day and then into the Topps Amateur Showcase. So here we go. Game one of the showcase. We're doing it all over again. It's deja vu. Just a year later. Year older, year wiser, hopefully. And maybe a year more mature with that pitching arm as well. I don't know. It's kind of a gamble. I mean, will he go higher in the draft than he did previously? Will he drop down farther? You know, will he have a good showing, a poor showing? There's a lot of questions on the table. You know, we've been through this once, been drafted. It's kind of a difficult thing throwing yourself back out there, but clearly the hope is that we climb the ladder a little bit, maybe go in higher rounds. And I mean, personally, selfishly, for this series, you know, we don't really want to follow the same path that Billy Bravo did to Baltimore. I'd kind of like to go somewhere else. We'll see how this shakes out. We're just going to give it another go in the showcase and see what happens. So he's going to be pitching against the West prospects today. Out on the mound. Feels like we've already done all this because we have. But our second go-around with the showcase starts with a fly ball to right and an out. First pitch, One pitch, one out. We'll take that efficiency going through here. He does work a 2-2 count to the next batter. Right-handed hitter will put it in play. It's going to be caught by the second baseman. Nice. He gets back there and makes the play. Thought it might drop in shallow right field, but that is not the case. So an 0-1 count trying to get out of the first inning. Pitch is put in play. Right back at him. Oh, yeah, he gloves that. Not going to let it get by him. Throws over to first. Ooh, almost pulled him off the bag, but nope, we're good. Out number three, three up, three down, and a good first inning for Tommie Johns. You guys, in one of my other videos, I was talking about this series, and I called them Jimmy Johns. I know I'm going to do it. I know I'm going to do it multiple times in this series, so hopefully I won't do it as many times as I'm fearing I will. It's Tommie Johns, not Jimmy Johns. That's the difference. You know, Tubby Emu named this guy Tommie Johns, you know, after, like, Tommie John surgery, the actual Tommie John. He told me he forgot all about the fact that there was a Tommie John that was actually the person that the surgery was named after. But anyway, I tend to go with crazy, like, food names. So, you know, we've had Curly Fry. We've had Red Bull. We've had all those kind of names out there. So, you know, if this were my guy, I probably would have named him Jimmy Johns. You know, let's not lie here. That's probably the way I would have gone. I like his choice. So Tommy is into the third inning now, and he's got a 1-0 lead, and he's got a pop-up behind third base. This is looking good. Okay, catch is made. Good stuff. Tommy's working here again today. Again, you know, another year wiser and maybe craftier as a pitcher. He is not allowed a hit so far, and he'll probably get two more batters or two more outs here at least. And finish through this third inning. So the next hitter is going to put the ball in play to center field. That looks like another out. And it is. Two up, two down in this inning. Can he work a clean three innings? This would be very nice for his chances of moving up in this year's draft as opposed to where he went last year in the 23rd round. That's in foul territory. Can he get there? Chase it down. Yes, he does. It's a 1-2-3 inning. He does not allow a hit in this outing, in the first game of the showcase. Assuming he will get pulled right here now after pitching three. Let somebody else have their chance, and it's Robbie McCormick coming out next for the Central. But that was good. That was very good for Tommie Johns. I have to imagine they'd be impressed with what he got done out there. So this one in the books. Central wins 4-3. Again, that's kind of the secondary aspect here. How the prospects performed individually is the A topic for scouts and media alike to follow along. So Tommie Johns, how we looking here? D potential? Come on, man. What's with the D potential? He pitched a clean three innings. I don't like to see that. Oh, well, I guess we just go out and try to improve upon that. How do you improve upon nine up and nine down? I mean, you don't really. I guess you just go out and try to duplicate it and show that you are consistent. So that's exactly what we will be trying to do today as we get going. The pep talk before we actually hit the field. This is the most important day of the rest of your life. That kind of stuff. I don't know. They're all watching you. Don't screw up. Depending on if this guy's a motivator or not. So Tommie Johns, 6'4", 215. He's 19 years old now. Was 18 in his first go-round, but he's 19 now. And he's back to the mound. All right. Tommie Johns, what you going to do for us today? Are we going to impress? Hopefully. First batter, 0-1 count. Sidearmer delivers. Up the middle, and that's through for a hit. Okay, there'll be no clean 9 up, 9 down today for him. That's okay. Needs to show that he can work with runners on as well. Show off all the skills. Any questions they have to answer about Tommie Johns, you can check the boxes there. Sacrifice bunt coming up. First baseman fields. Throws to the second baseman covering, and they've got their out. So one out. Traded for the runner into scoring position at second base. Can Tommie neutralize this? We'll find out right now. Here is he works to the next batter. First pitch is put in play. It's to left field. This should be good. Make that catch, and the runner goes back to second base. You now have two outs. All right, and this seems like a much less threatening situation now, especially with an 0-2 count. Leaves the pitch up, but it is hit high in the air. High fly ball right fielder makes the easy catch. Runner stranded and crisis averted there for Tommie Johns. One inning down, two to go for him. Come on back out here. We have no score. We have a 2-2 count to the leadoff hitter of the inning. And he will strike out. Okay, we now have one down, and we're looking pretty good. If I do say so, let's just keep through. Keeping limber there, keeping stretching. Making sure the arm is loose, that the back doesn't stiffen up. And meanwhile, we see a replay of where this ends up. And that must have been off speed because he was way in front of that. And looked a little foolish. So 2-2 count to the next batter, who is a left-handed hitter. And comes inside, and it might have grazed him. Yeah, I think he got him. He's hit by pitch and will take his base. Let's watch and see where this gets him. Yeah, plunked him in the shoulder. Okay, 1-2 count to the next batter. Can we get a double play ball? No, but we get strike three looking. Nice placement on that pitch, although the batter doesn't agree. That's okay, though. He's not the one calling balls and strikes. He can get mad all he wants, but he's got to go back to the dugout to do it. Nice pitch here. Tommie getting the call. I could see, you know, it's a little low, but I think it caught the strike zone. He might have a little beef. Whatever. He's rung up, and so is that guy. Go sit down, buddy. Swing the bat, maybe, if you want to have a chance to get on base. Because the ump is calling those pitches for Tommie Johns just fine for our liking. He's through two innings now, and we have no score. Third inning, still no score. Again, he's getting that low call. You guys should know by now that's his strike zone. Don't know what you're waiting for. We're going to keep putting it right there if he's going to give us that call. Another strikeout collected by Tommie Johns, and we are mowing him down. One out in the third. Again, this pitch right about the borderline of the strike zone. These hitters just don't think that's going to be called a strike, and they're wrong. This pitch is going to be put in play as that is fielded by the third baseman, and we've got out number two. He's got just one more to get here, and then his showcase will be complete with a very nice performance. And we're getting ahead of ourselves. We got one more batter to take care of. I mean, he could light us up for a home run, and then it might not look so good, but let's buckle down and get this guy. 1-1 count. Left-handed batter. Should be in our advantage. Ball put in play. And can the shortstop get there? Did he make the catch? Oh, man, he did not. That ball dropped somehow. Not hit hard at all, but placed well, I guess. This is a pop-up. We should be done here now. Third baseman, get that. Thank you. All right. All in all, pretty good. Just a bloop hit in that inning. And did not come around to score, didn't even get to second base. It's Robbie McCormick coming in again, get his work in. But the day of work is done for Tommie Johns, and now you just wait around for this game to be over, head back home, and flip on the draft again. We'll see what round we go in this time around. I don't know. I think we would move up. I mean, I don't know what else they want us to do. We didn't allow any runs. Not very many hits overall either. So, I don't know. It's up to the scouts now to determine those things. They know where we got drafted last year.
Welcome back to the Major League Baseball first-year player draft. The first pick is officially on the clock. With the first pick, the Detroit Tigers select Michael Valdez, a center fielder from the East Region. With the second pick, the San Francisco Giants select Carlos Palacios, a closing pitcher from the East Region. With the third pick, the Philadelphia Phillies select Javier Ordóñez, a relief pitcher from the East Region. With the fourth pick, the Chicago White Sox select Mario Cedeño, a catcher from the East Region. With the 16th pick, the Tampa Bay Rays select Tommie Johns, a starting pitcher from the Central Region.
Wow, so we actually dropped. I don't know if it's because we're a year older and considered that we don't have as much potential time in our career, but we went 28th round this time to the Tampa Bay Rays. I think we're probably just going to go with that since it's something different for us.
Once again as last year, this returning candidate gets a call from his advisor on the third day of the MLB draft.
Do you kind of get the feeling from the narrator that he's kind of like, blah, 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 make up your mind, move forward. He sounds bored with our story kind of there. Once again, as last year. Anyway, we're talking to the advisor here. And, you know, maybe I read Tommy wrong. Maybe he's not going to sign with Tampa Bay. Maybe he's going to give it yet another try one more year around. I think he is. I think he's actually going to go back. So it'll be another year in college of seasoning, another showcase coming up, and I'm pretty sure the third time will be the last. So Tommie Johns, drafted twice, still not satisfied. Third time will be the charm. Well, to see you next time. We'll see you then.